Hi, I'm Kev Lavery, and today I'm going to talk you through using a rubric to mark an observation. Now, first up, it's probably worth clarifying that this is for units which have had rubrics applied to them. Not all units will have them, some won't need them, and others won't hit the stage of renewal where they've been added yet. They're not something that you as a teacher need to add. They're something that's added as part of master product, so if they're not in your unit, then just keep doing things the way you always have been. In terms of doing things the way that you already have been, these rubrics have been built to replicate that. They're basically a digital version of what you were doing on paper. It's just in this format you can do them on your phone, a tablet, or a computer, and you don't need to worry about downloading or uploading or transferring the results over. Rubrics are just another way to mark an assignment, so these will appear in the Assignments tool and in the Assessments module of your unit, so both you and your students will be able to access them easily. Here, we're going to be talking about a rubric that's tied to an observation. For info about rubrics for written assignments, or any other assignment with a submission component, check out our Rubrics for Submissions video. So how do you mark an observation? Like everything in Connect, there's a variety of ways to do this, but this way, going through the Assignments tool, is the only one that we recommend. You could have gotten to the Assignments tool through the navbar, via Quick Eval, or some other way, but the important thing is that this is your starting point. We need to navigate to the assessment and to the correct attempt, and select View Submissions from the context menu. In here, you'll see the option to evaluate next to students whose observations are yet to be completely evaluated. Selecting that opens up the assignment's evaluation and feedback area. Select the rubric to open it. From here, it's like it is on a paper rubric. Make sure you mark every criteria, yes or no, as to whether a student demonstrated competency or not. Connect will auto-save your marking as you go, and any criteria that you've marked will stay there if you close it. This is useful in situations where you don't or can't mark an assessment all in one sitting, as well as situations where you might switch devices during marking. If you do close the rubric unfinished, it will alert you to this. There's a spot on each criteria to add feedback, so be sure to take advantage of that, especially in situations where the student has not demonstrated competency. And then, once you've marked off every criteria and given feedback where appropriate, mark whether they were satisfactory or unsatisfactory at the bottom of the rubric in the overall score section and select Close. That overall score doesn't actually transfer through to the grade score, so you as a teacher need to fill that in manually. At TAFE Queensland, that just means one of three numbers. 0. Did not submit. 1. Unsatisfactory. Or 2. Satisfactory. And like with all assignments, you'll have the option to add a little bit of overall feedback on this assessment before you publish the grade and send it back to the student. This is especially important in situations where the student has been unsuccessful. When marking a second attempt, you don't need to remark the entire rubric, just the sections where the student wasn't successful on their first attempt. As a result, it's good practice to reference those criteria in the assignment feedback area. It's good for the student so they know what will be the focus of the next attempt, and you'll need to know what you do and don't need to mark on the next attempt. The rubric for a second attempt will only need to have the criteria being observed marked. As well as the overall satisfactory or unsatisfactory. And of course you'll need to manually add the grade score as before and an explanation in the feedback about what criteria was marked. If you have any questions about best practice in using rubrics for the sorts of assessments you're doing, have a chat with your local educator capability team.